Hi guys!
Hi!
We are back and we are reacting to the second music video
that
Taylor Swift
has
done now.
Wow.
As you guys probably know, we were obviously in Paris to react to the Midnight's album, but then in the few days after that, you know, we were chilling, exploring, but then we're also flying home.
We're home. We're doing all of our fathoming today.
With
jet lag and all.
Jet lag and all. Yes, we're still in our jet lag era. I'm super excited.
Yeah,
I am super excited to watch this music video.
We don't even know what song this music video is, right?
We have been like off social media entirely because we didn't want any spoilers at all.
Yeah, at least we had the flight to just be disconnected from everything.
Yes, and just listen to the album.
Yeah, listen to
which was quite
so superior. I have a theory that it might be Vigilante shit because it was the other one with the upside down phone.
Yeah. Yes.
But I'm also just like, have no idea. She could fuck us up with anything.
We're just going to search Taylor Swift in YouTube and see what happens.
Bejeweled! Oh my God, I was not expecting Bejeweled.
Oh my God. You know, this might actually make some sense because a few of those visuals... In the trailer, the NFL trailer that she released with the hints and stuff, there was a lot of like jeweled vibes.
Oh my God, yeah.
You know, it's
there
also
was,
really...
and also with the first you know outfit that she wore at the VMAs as well. I love Bejeweled. I think it's such a bop, and I think it's a great
single. You just
said
something there. It's quite funny because we were actually, I think the day that we reacted to the album as well, you said that you can't actually really pick like what the singles would be. Because there's actually so many bops on this album that I think would work as a single. It's like, it's hard to actually pick exactly which ones would be singles. And, you know, it's actually quite funny what she's doing this era. Are we considering the ones with music videos singles? Like, I think traditionally speaking, a single gets a music video. So I'm kind of going with... it's a single.
Yeah.
But it's a really interesting rollout because obviously we didn't get a single before the album was released. We got the anti-hero music video the day that she released the album. And then this only came a few days later, which is interesting in and of itself because there's not really been like a huge amount of space for anti-hero as a single to breathe.
Yeah, yeah. No.
But I also think that we're at an age with the music industry now where you don't really...
things are being done differently.
Yeah, like you maybe don't really need to follow that traditional trend of like, you know, waiting a few months between singles and stuff to promote the album. She doesn't need singles to promote the album anymore. She just speaks and it's promoted. You know, like
literally.
It's just a completely different age.
Well, and God, can we talk about the fact that she broke the records? She absolutely smashed all of the records. Like,
yes.
I didn't believe Emily when she told me.
I said to you, I was like, you know that Taylor Swift broke like the first day, like album debut streams in Spotify history, and you were like, you mean like the female streams? I'm like, no, like of all time. And you were like, no, like the record is like 150 million. That's impossible. And I'm like, I'm pretty sure it was like 180 million. And I was like, maybe I'm wrong. And then we looked it up and it was like,
because Folklore only got 90 million streams. So I was not expecting it to literally double.
No, I really don't understand how she keeps doing this. I don't understand. Like, I do.
I
do understand. This is a superior album.
Taylor doesn't do what you want her to do either.
No.
If she did that, then she wouldn't be Taylor Swift. She wouldn't be someone who reinvents herself and re-evolves every single day.
How?
She's ahead of the people.
I am so excited to watch this music.
I can't believe it's Bejeweled.
Guys, let's fathom.
Bejeweled. Oh my God, I'm so excited.
Oh, this is some of her best work.
Wait, can I also...
that was an offensive thing that they just said.
Oh my God, this is some of her best work. Oh, this album, absolutely, you're right.
Some of her best work.
I wonder if we're going to get the rest of those clips in this music video or if there's going to be clips from that NFL preview that's not in this either.
That's tea, because that gives
and whether it indicates that there's going to be
another
music videos coming.
That's so much tea.
Yeah.
And I wonder if this is the one that's going to include Jack Antonoff, because we know from the other one that it features Jack Antonoff somewhere.
Tea.
On this sparkling evening, I'll be releasing my twist on a fairy tale we all know.
Oh, I literally
the one
just
about
said
a girl
Cinderella vibes.
And her stepsisters and the clock striking midnight. The video is wild, whimsical, and created specifically for you. Oh, interesting.
My beloved fans! Oh. If it's made for us, I feel like it could be giving Easter eggs.
It says specifically in capital letters.
Oh my God.
Wait, we have to pay attention. Oh my God.
This is Cinderella. I love this.
I can't believe she's doing Cinderella vibes.
Yeah, that's iconic.
Oh my God, who are the sisters going to be?
No, I'm sorry, my.
The Home Girls! Oh my god!
Oh my god.
You just know Esty is gonna make the best. A wicked sister. Oh my god, this is so fancy.
And obviously we knew from the NFL premiere that the Hind sisters were going to be in a music video.
I'm so sorry, Taylor looks
if everyone mentioned in the starring part of that NFL premiere thing
is not in this,
then we know that there's also other music videos coming. Like, is Laura Dern in this music video?
You're right.
Is Dita Von Teese in this music video?
Right.
Is it just the Heim sisters? Do you know what I mean?
That's gonna be absolutely
No, I'm sorry, my dudes. He's gonna choose me. I even contoured my abs with the mud from the hog pen outside, so.
Well, I bought diamond nipple tassels, so.
Well, I'll be poisoning all the other
maids.
Okay. I love Laura Dern.
There she is.
I love Laura Dern.
No, she's such an icon.
I love the Heim sisters. No, this is offensive.
I wonder if, like, you know, because Laura Dern's in Big Little Lies as well, isn't
yes.
she? Yeah, so interesting with Zoe Kravis, like that whole crew.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
True.
Well, I'll be poisoning all the other maidens in the village.
Yes, mom.
But I love how they're their vocabulary is like very current.
But this is the most iconic thing I've ever seen. Taylor Swift and her evil stepsisters are the Heim sisters, and their mother is Laura Dern. Help me now.
Oh my god. This is the most offensive visual I've ever seen. And
oh my
Taylor
god.
Looks
my Jurassic Park queen.
Like the most perfect human. In that Cinderella.
No, she does. In that Cinderella fit. She doesn't even... She can be like the poor girl on the floor and she still looks the
she
most superior.
Looks so superior.
No, I love Danielle so much. Oh my god. Dying.
They're changing it this year. So instead of just showing up at the ball looking hot, you have to enter a talent competition. And if you win, you get the keys to your own castle. And a marriage proposal from the prince.
Lady Danielle wants the ring. Lady Esty wants the title. Lady Alana wants the D!
So I thought it reminds me of the lyric, like, you wanted ass, what's wrong with that?
Also, house wench Taylor wants
the
castle. Of course she's going to enter a talent show and be superior.
Her eyes kind of sparked up when they said castle.
Absolutely. I think this is where it's going. Wait, I had something to say. I am so happy that in these last couple of eras, Taylor has really been involving the Heim sisters. Because once again, I think that she is... She's really found her people
friends.
and learn over the years which ones are the ones that have stuck around, the ones that always support her and have her back no matter what and won't betray her.
No.
The Heim sisters
and
have been around since
either.
At least Red era, and I love.
Well, we all know who's not coming tonight. That weasel down there cleaning up my sick from last night.
You must clean my bed pot next.
We honestly have to do this entire verbal abuse thing every time you leave the house.
Shut up, wench!
Stop it!
You smell! Nobody cares.
Speak not, tired, tacky wench. Clean. Ugh, ladies, worry not. Even if she were allowed to go, which she is not, the prince would never have anything to do with that little harlot again. He tired of her quite quickly, didn't he? Or should I say swiftly?
There it is. That joke never gets old. Thank you. Thank you so much.
So iconic.
We haven't even started the song yet, and we're a minute and a half in. This is so
deeply superior. Wait, I love that they're kind of referencing that they did have a moment.
Yes, and also who was the prince?
And who was the prince? Because this song is about, you know, best believe I'm still bejeweled, you lost a good thing here, like kind of someone taking her for granted. Mm-hmm. So I wonder if she's not even really gonna give a fuck about him.
Totally.
Take the castle
and just
or something.
Be after the talent show prize.
Oh my
yes.
god, this is gonna be I am so overwhelmed at what I'm about to witness. This storyline, the imagery so far, the acting so far, I cannot handle it.
This is already my favorite.
Yeah.
And like, anti-hero was superior, but I'm so sorry. Whatever is happening here, I'm so overwhelmed.
This is deeply superior.
You've been exiled here. You're not going anywhere.
We love an exile reference.
Oh my god, you know, I wonder if now, if I pay attention, everything that Laura Dern has been saying is like names of her songs and stuff, because she said, I thought she said Speak Now before or Speak Something. I don't know if that's happened or not, but maybe.
Certainly not the ball.
Now, girls,
let's get many, many jewels. Yes.
Bye. Bye, snake.
Have fun being exiled, stinky.
I'm gonna be hungover. I'm gonna drink a bunch of different drinks.
No.
Can you explain that if people yes. don't know?
If you didn't know, they did a TikTok a few months ago exactly singing yeah. that. I'm gonna be hungover. And it became like a TikTok trend yeah. to like do that sound as well.
A little smile.
Written and directed.
Baby love, yes.
I think I've been a little too kind.
Yeah, we think so too.
Yes. Was that Jack?
I think it was Jack Angel.
Oh my god, can we go back?
Is Jack gonna be the prince?
Oh my god, don't.
It's Jack.
That is Jack! Oh my god! If Jack's the prince, I'm gonna die.
Jack's gonna be the prince, I think.
Didn't notice you walking all over my peace of mind. And the shoes I gave you as a present. Putting someone first only works when you're in their top.
Exile ends.
Bye.
Yes.
And by the way.
Oh, that's oh giving God. Reputation. It's also giving Willow music video.
Yeah.
Best believe I'm still bejeweled. When I walk in the room, I can still make the whole place shimmer.
Oh my God.
Band, they asked, do you have a man?
Yes.
I say I don't remember.
Three? Did she press 1, 3 or just 3?
I think just 3.
In the basement when I want the penthouse of your heart. Diamonds in my
oh, she looks so good there.
With the blue eyeshadow, which is giving the cover of the album.
No, I cannot deal
oh
with
that. Oh my god, it's like a ball
good.
Gown or something underneath.
Oh my god, she looks so good.
Baby boy, I think
strap in that dress. Oh, it's a little.
Oh.
Oh my god, all the jewels are crying onto her.
Think it's time to teach some lessons. Have you heard? I can make a
statement.
And I miss you.
No, I'm so sorry. I think that necklace might be the same. Is that the same jewels as on, the bracelet? Like with the albums?
All the album colors, yeah. Yeah, and maybe all over her body is like bigger versions of that as well. Like all
maybe,
of her, and maybe that's like symbolic of her saying like claim the land. Like
all I can
her,
reclaim the land. I can reclaim all of her music.
Yeah, all of them
by re-recording
coming back
it.
To her as jewels because they are her jewels.
Yes.
I love that this song like for me has a double meaning about that. Like that her albums are her jewels and that like, she's reclaiming them and you know she is still bejeweled even after
which
they've taken
them
from her.
Which is a lyric in Mighty's Ricochet.
Yeah,
and I love how she's kind of. Taken that and run with it, like the albums being jewels, because there is that merch bracelet that has, you know, the albums in order. What is the lyric in Mighty's Ricochet again?
You wear the same jewels that I gave you as you bury me.
Yes. Oh my god.
And I miss
I love her hair.
Same.
But her fringe put down like that?
Yes.
Oh, what's that? A little clock that says it say 13 or 12. It's 13.
And that is her albums in order. Green, yellow, purple, red, blue, Reputation, Lover, Folklore, Evermore, Fearless, red, Midnight. What the fuck is that?
Oh god, it's purple. It's Speak Now.
This would be perfect coming off the back of like Would Have, Could Have, Should Have being the second last song on like the whole like main album with the 3am edition tracks because
that's
obviously is a Speak Now throwback. You know, when she first announced this album and said it was like Midnights in Her Life, we obviously all did have theories about whether or not there could be older songs written in the past or songs that, you know, refer back to different times in their life. And we know now that a lot of the songs on this album do reference like past relationships and stuff like that as well, which, you know, makes, it leads us to believe that in re-recording her previous albums, a lot of those emotions and thoughts about, you know, hindsight on those relationships and stuff would have come up for her. And so to write about them from a, you know, a present day perspective and having that time gone by makes perfect sense.
Totally.
I'm so sorry, but that is fucking purple. Guys, I think she just gave us a speak now next Easter. I'm so unwell. That is an Easter egg if I ever saw a fucking Easter egg. Actually, might not be a clock. It might just be the levels.
It is, yeah, the levels.
Yeah, I think at first we were like, it's a clock. No, I actually think it's the levels on the elevator. But I wonder
what level she's going to get off if it's at midnight.
It would make sense if she gets off at 12.
Yeah, it would.
She just get off at 1989. She just got off at 1989. Sis is getting off at 1989.
Oh, I'm so unwell.
Short. Oh my god! Okay, I have a feeling that maybe so far this means that we do kind of have most of the people that were named at the end of that trailer. She is credited with repopularizing burlesque performance, earning the moniker Queen of Burlesque.
Ah, okay, Queen of Burlesque.
That's her thing. And it's blue.
Yeah, it is. And her hair is short. Yeah. I'm so sorry.
No, that's villainy. Oh my god. Oh my god. No. But she looks so good. I can't even deal. I love this!
Oh my god, what are they gonna do? Oh my god, so cute! Oh, dance! Oh, dance! Take your stockings up!
All night, and you can try to change my mind, but you might have to wait in line. What's a girl gonna do?
The camera cut out, but we were just literally been watching with our mouths like, open because we can't believe what we're witnessing. Taylor Swift bathing in a martini glass.
No, it's too
in the 1989
much
level.
On the 1989 level. What's a girl gonna do? A diamond
gotta shine. She went to the 13th level.
Oh my god, this is her entering the talent show. Oh, no, no, it looks so good. Look at her outfit.
Oh my god, her belly button. So, wait, I'm still processing that she went to the 5th level and then she went to the 13th level, to the speak now level. Like, what do you mean?
I am so
Are we
going
to get another 1989 song and then speak now, the album?
She does love to drip feed 1989 songs.
Yeah. Because we're not going to get the album because otherwise the album would have been there. But are we just having a little stopover at 1989? Why did she get off there? I'm so confused. But anyway, we're back here now and now she's doing all this dancing.
That's like giving stopwatch with the whole...
And it's at the 3. Speak Now is the 3rd album.
No, you're right. It's on the 3. Yeah,
It's on the 3. And that's
oh my
the room
god.
That she's in now. And maybe...
She is midnight and the next is number 3. She is the 12.
She is the 12.
Oh my god.
And I also feel like it's like, you know, it's a self-written album and it's like just her up there on the talent show.
Absolutely. You're right.
And look at all the jelly. Oh, she looks amazing.
No, she looks so good. I love this outfit. Oh, she looks so good.
Who are you?
That's Zoe Kravitz.
Queen Pat
was impressed. I'm not entirely sure who that is.
No.
Or who this lady is. Can't say I know for sure.
Is it giving Bridgerton?
It kind of is giving Bridgerton.
Like how the queen picks the best girl?
Yes, absolutely. Yes, it is.
Because he gives me Bridgerton as well, but I don't know.
It is, it is. Yeah, but I don't know if that is him. I don't know. I don't know.
But that is definitely Zoe Kravitz.
Yeah, that's definitely Zoe Kravitz. Prince Jack was forced to propose to house wench Taylor.
Yeah.
I got... That's the key. That is a key.
That is a key for the castle. They look iconic. Look at them. Oh my god, wait, there was something in her hair. Sorry, I needed to fathom that. Just a diamond with S on
it.
No,
is that an N? Speak now.
Oh my god, I think it is.
Is it?
Oh my fucking god. This oh, is she ghosted?
What you doing? Oh, he's like, okay.
Oh, and now it says TS.
Now it says TS. But kept the castle.
Of course you did, doll.
Oh, and castle's giving Speak Now vibes as well. And...
wow.
Dragon!
Oh, dragon.
Go the there's, fuck off. Wait, she's in the Sansa Arya era.
Dragons. She's in her Daenerys
she's
era.
She's in her Daenerys era.
Oh my
with
god.
Also with her third album coming.
Absolutely. Oh my god, yes, three dragons. Stop it.
No, I'm so sorry. That was rude and offensive music video. I loved that. I need to watch that a million times.
Same. Oh my god,
if this is how amazing the music videos are going to be this time, I can't even imagine what's to come. Oh my, I'm so sorry. There were scenes in the trailer that we have not seen.
You
like,
reckon?
Yeah, like the one where she's dancing in that blue shirt and she runs her hands across his back.
Oh my god, you're right. That means we're getting other music videos.
Wait, I feel like I need to fathom.
I think you're right. It is kind of giving lavender haze. Yeah. There's a lot of purple.
Yeah.
But gosh, who knows?
That was so fucking good. That was so good. I love that music video. I cannot believe we got some Speak Now hints. Cannot believe she did that to us. There's probably more that we have not even fathomed.
Absolutely. If there is Easter eggs that we did not pick up on, please let us know in the comments.
That was so much fun. I love being in a new era. That was so good. Visuals? What do you mean?
But you know, it really is exciting the fact that like we still have four re-recordings to come, because even though we are in a new era, thank you so much Taylor Swift for giving us an entirely new album during your re-record era. Like that's a lot the first place. But the fact that we're actually getting more re-records and that we probably will get at least another one during this era, because her eras usually go for like almost 2 years, right? If she's making this a proper era, that's so offensive to know that there's more coming in amongst all of that.
This cannot be stopped. It's so concerning how talented and how hard-working she is. There's no one else like her on the planet.
No.
And being her fan is a privilege.
No, she's too superior.
She's too superior.
Oh my god. Anyways, thank you so much for watching.
And we'll see you guys in another video.
Yay, bye.